Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpandi. I am happy to meet you through this video lecture series on the subject digital mass transfer. We are discussing Module 5, Radiation Heat Transfer. And this is the lecture number 5, Radiation Shape Factor Problems. So we are going to solve few problems on the radiation shape factor calculations. And in the previous lecture, we defined what is shape factor, and we discussed the shape factor relationship like reciprocity rule, summation rule, superposition rule. So there are different rules for the relationship between the shape factor that we have discussed. And the shape factor is determined from the diagrams. So the various diagrams are available in the heat and mass transfer data book. We discussed the diagrams. So now today we solve problems on the shape factor using those diagrams and relationship. And the learning outcome for this lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the shape factor calculation on their own. And this is example number 9. Consider a thin hollow cylinder of 8 cm diameter and 10 cm length. If the radian shape factor of the circular surfaces is 0.172, find the shape factor of the curved surface of the cylinder with respect to itself. So here there are the surfaces, and the surface 1 is the top cylindrical surface, surface 2 is the bottom cylindrical surface, and the surface 3 is the curved surface connecting the two top and the bottom circles. And here R1 equal to R2 equal to 4, this equal to 0.04 meter, 4 centimeter, which is 0.04 meter. Length of the cylinder is 0.1 meter. And here from the surfaces, they are exchanging heat by radiation. So the heat radiation leaving from the surface 1 is partially falling on the surface 3 and falling on the surface 2. Similarly, the surface 2, the heat is falling on the surface 3 and surface 1. And the heat leaving from the surface 3 is falling on surface 1, surface 2 and on the surface itself. So because it is a curved surface, the heat leaving from the surface 3 is partially falling on the surface itself. Now, what is given in the problem? Shape factor between the surfaces 1 and 2, the circular surfaces, F12 equal to F21 equal to 0.172. Now, what is the question? We have to calculate the shape factor of the curved surface of the cylinder with respect to itself. So, F33 we have to calculate. So, F33. So, we will see how to calculate. First, for the surface 1, summing rules, summation, using the summation rule. What is summation rule? The sum of the shape factor from a particular surface is equal to 1. So for the surface 1, F11 plus F12 plus F13 equal to 0. F11 is the amount of heat leaving surface 1, fraction of heat leaving the surface 1, which is falling on the surface 1. The fraction of heat energy leaving the surface 1, which is falling on the surface 2. And the fraction of heat energy leaving the surface 1, that is falling on the surface 3, the sum is equal to 1. And here, for the cylindrical surface, it is a flat surface. So, F11 equal to 0. What is F11? The amount of heat leaving the surface 1, which is falling on the surface 1, is equal to 0. Because it is not falling on the surface 1. So, amount of heat leaving from the 1, it is falling either on 3 or 2. So, F13 equal to 1 minus F12 equal to 1 minus F12 is given as 0.172, so F13 equal to 0.828. Similarly, for the surface 2, using the summation rule, F21 plus F22 plus F23 equal to 1, F22 equal to 0. So, as we said earlier, F22, the amount of heat leaving from the surface 2, which is falling on the surface 2 again, which is 0. So, F23 equal to 1 minus F21 equal to 1 minus 0.17 equal to 0.828. Now, the area of the surfaces. So A1 equal to A2 equal to pi r square, which is pi into 0.04 square equal to 5.024 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. And A3 is the surface area of the curved surface 2 pi r into L, which is 2 pi into 0.04 into 0.1 equal to 0.02512 meter square. Now, using the reciprocity rule, A1 F13 equal to A3 F31. So, F31 equal to A1 F13 divided by A3 equal to 5.024 in 10 power minus 3 is A1 divided by A3 equal to 0.02512 into F31 equal to 0.828, which is 0.1656. And again, reciprocity rule, F23 equal to A2 F23 equal to A3 F32. So, F32 equal to A2 F23 divided by A3, which is 5.024 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 0.02512 into 0.828 equal to 0.1656. Now, again, using the summation, rule for surface 3, F31 plus F32 plus F33 equal to 1. So, F33 equal to 1 minus F31 minus F32 equal to 1 minus 0.1656 minus 0.1656 equal to 0.6688. So, the answer is shape factor of the curved surface with respect to itself, F33 equal to 0.6688. And this is example number 10. A truncated cone has top and the bottom diameters as of 10 centimeter and 20 centimeter and height of 10 centimeter. Calculate the shape factor between top surface and the side, and also the shape factor between side and itself. So these are the bottom cylinder, bottom circle of diameter 0.1 meter, top circle of the diameter 0.05 meter, and height equal to 0.1 meter. So this is radius is given, diameter is given, we are calculating the radius. Now area of the bottom surface, A1 equal to pi r1 square equal to 3.14 into 0.1 square, is equal to 0.0314 meter square, and the area of the bottom top circle, this is pi r2 square, which is 3.14 into 0.05 square, which is 7.85 into 10 power minus 3 meter square, and the area of the curved surface for the truncated cone, A3 equal to pi into r1 plus r2 into square root of r1 minus r2 whole square plus l square. So 3.14 into 0.1 plus 0.05 into square root of 0.1 minus 0.05 square plus 0.1 square, which is 0.0526 meter square. So all the three areas were calculated. Now you have to use this graph from your Hindle Master's data book. Use the graph. There are two parameters, L by R1 and R2 by L. So L by R1 is here, which is L equal to 0.1, R1 equal to 0.1 equal to 1, and R2 by L 0.05 divided by 0.1 equal to 0.5. So L by R1 equal to L by power 1 and R2 by L equal to 0.5, and taking the value, so the F12 equal to 0.11. So shape factor from this diagram, from your Hidden Master's data book, it is 0.11. And using the summation rule, so F11 plus F12 plus F13 equal to 1. So for the base circle, F11 equal to 0. So F13 equal to 1 minus F12, which is 1 minus 0.11 equal to 0.89. And using the reciprocity rule, A1 F12 equal to A2 F21. So F21 equal to A1 F12 plus A2 is equal to 0.0314 into 0.11. Divided by 7.85 10 power minus 3 equal to 0.44. And using the summation rule for the surface 2, A21 plus A22 plus A23 equal to 0. So here A22 equal to 0 because it's the flat surface at the top. So F23 equal to 1 minus F21, this equal to 1 minus 0.04 equal to 0.56. Now the reciprocity rule once again, A1 F13 equal to A3 F31. So F31 equal to A1 F13 divided by A3, this is 0.0314 into 0.89, F13 is 0.89 divided by 0.0526, which is equal to 0.53. Now, for using the reciprocity rule for A2F23 equal to A3F32. So F32 equal to A2F23 by A3, which is 7.85 10 power minus 3 into 0.56 divided by 0.052 is equal to 0.083. So this is using again the summation rule between for the third surface, F31 plus F32 plus F33 equal to 1. So F33 equal to 1 minus F31 minus F32 is equal to 1 minus 0.53 minus 0.083 equal to 0.387. Now the answer to the problem is shape factor between top surface and the side surface F23 equal to 0.56 and shape factor between side and itself F33 equal to 0.387. And you consider 11, example 11, consider two concentric cylinders having diameters 10 cm and the 20 cm and length of 20 cm. Designating the open of the cylinders as surface 3 and 4, estimate the shape factor F34. And this is the diagram. The concentric cylinders, the inner cylinder is 1, outer cylinder is 2. And in the radiation heat transfer, we take the one, the surface one, outer surface of the inner cylinder. So the outer surface of the inner cylinder is 1 and 2 is the inner surface of the outer cylinder. So this is the outer cylinder, inner surface is 2. And this surface front end, this is the 3 and this face is the 4. Now we have to calculate the shape factor F34. So, what are the possibilities of radiation heat transfer? So, the surface 1, the heat leaving from the surface 1 is falling on surface 2, that is inner surface of the cylinder, and surface 4 and surface 3. Now, similarly, the heat leaving from the surface 2 is falling on 1, 3 and 4. So, that is what the arrangement. Now, the data given are R1 equal to 0.05 meter, R2 equal to 0.1 meter and L equal to 0.2 meter. Area of the cylinders, A1 equal to 2 pi R1 into L, which is 2 into pi into 0.05 into 0.2, which is 0.068 meter square. And the A2 equal to 2 pi R2 into L, which is 2 into pi into 0.1 into 0.2, which is 0.1256 meter square. Now, this is the diagram for calculating the shape factor from the data book. So, this diagram is the concentric cylinder of inner radius R1, outer radius R2. And this diagram gives the F21. F21 means from the inner surface of the cylinder to the outer surface of the inner cylinder, F21. And this diagram gives the shape factor F22. That is the heat leaving the surface 1, which is falling on the surface 2. So F22, F21. And what are the parameters are L by R2, the lines for L by R2. And R1 by R2, this is on the x-axis. So, x-axis R1 by R2, the curve for L by R2, and here also x-axis is R1 by R2, and the line for L by R2, and here the diagram is F22, right? Now, for the given value, calculated value for 2 and L by R2 equal to 2, R1 by R2 equal to 0.5, the shape factor equal to F21 equal to 0.44, and from here R1 by R2 equal to 0.5 and this L by R2 equal to 2, the shape factor is 0.34. So F21 equal to 0.44 and F22 equal to 0.34. So this you have to take from your heat and mass transfer data book. Now using the reciprocity rule, A1 F12 equal to A2 F21. So, F12 equal to A2 F21 divided by A1, which is 0.1256 into 0.44 divided by A1 equal to 0.0628 equal to 0.80. Using the symmetry rule, F23 equal to F24 equal to F24. Similarly, F13 equal to F14. So, this is the symmetry rule. What do you mean by this F23 equal to F24? The heat leaving the surface 1 is equally falling on the 3 and the 4. So, 3 is the left side surface and 4 is the right side surface. Similarly, F13 equal to F14. And using the summation rule, F21 plus F22 plus F23 plus F24 equal to 1. So, here using this relationship, F23 equal to F24. So 2 F23 equal to 1 minus F21 minus F22, which is 1 minus 0.44 minus 0.34 equal to 0.22. So F23 equal to 0.22 divided by 2 equal to 0.11. Similarly, using the summation rule, F11 plus F12 plus F13 plus F14 equal to 1. And here we have F13 equal to F14. So 2 F13 equal to 1 minus F12 equal to 1 minus 0.88 equal to 0.12. So F13 equal to 0.06 because F11 equal to 0 here. Right. Then using reciprocity rule, A1 F13 equal to A3 F31. So F31 equal to A1 F13 divided by A3. So calculating 0.0628 into 0.06 divided by 0.02355, which is equal to 0.16. And A2 F23 equal to A3 F32. So F32 equal to A2 F23 divided by A3, which is 0.1256 into 0.11 divided by 0.02355 equal to 0.587. And using the summation rule again, F31 plus F32 plus F33 plus F34 equal to 1. So F34 equal to 1 minus F31 minus F32, which is 1 minus 0.16 minus 0.187 equal to 253. F33 equal to 0. So the shape factor F34 equal to 0.253 is the answer to the problem. And we take the next example, example number 12. This is from a university question paper. Determine the view factor F14 for the figure shown in the diagram. So this is what the diagram shown given in the question paper. So we have perpendicular two plates have a common edge. This is the horizontal plate, this is the vertical plate, and the horizontal plate has two segments, 1 and 2. The vertical plate has got the two segments, 3 and 4, and the side, the each square, the area equal to 1 meter square. That means A1 equal to A2 equal to A3 equal to A4 equal to 1 meter square. And here we combine 1 and 2, we call it as surface 5. And we combine 3 and 4, we call it as surface 6. So A5 equal to A1 plus A2, which is 2 meter square. And A5 equal to A3 plus A4, which is again 2 meter square. And this is the diagram to calculate the shape factor. So A1, this is A2. So this length equal to Y and this height equal to Z. And the horizontal width equal to x meter. So here for the diagram, for example, if you take 2, so y equal to 1, x equal to 1. If you take 3, z equal to 1 and x equal to 1. If you take 6, then you have the z equal to 2 and x equal to 1. So if you take 5, then y equal to 2 and x equal to 1. So the understand the diagram. So the we have to calculate the A5, A6, A1, A2, A3, A4. Then for F5, 6, suppose we are going to calculate the shape factor between the surface 5, which is 1 and 2 combined, and the surface 6, again 3 and 4 combined. Y equal to 2, z equal to 2. X equal to 1 always. X equal to 1 for all the diagram. Then for 2, 6, 2 and 6, so this small square and this vertical rectangle. So y equal to 1 and z equal to 2. 2, 3, y equal to 1, z equal to 1. And for 5, 3, so 5 entire base and height, this height 3, y equal to 2 and z equal to 1. So this is what the calculation, x value, y value for different combination. Now, this is what the chart we are going to use for calculating the shape factor, and this is the arrangement. So, for 5, 6, y equal to 2, z equal to 2. So, y equal to 2, z equal to 2, and you have to find the shape factor, and the shape factor F56 equal to 0.1493, F26 equal to 0.23285, and F23 equal to 0.20004. And F53 equal to 0.11643. So all the four shape factors we have to take from this chart, from this diagram, from your heat and mass transfer data. Then we have the additive rule. F45 equal to F41 plus F42 is equal to, from here we calculate F41, which is equal to F45 minus F42. And similarly, F56 is equal to F53 plus F54. So F54 equal to F56 minus F53. And F26 equal to F24 plus 23. So F24 equal to F26 minus 23. A simple arithmetic calculation, additive rule. And using the reciprocity rule, A4 F45 equal to A5 F45. So from here we calculate F45, which is A5 F54 divided by A4, and this F54, from here this is F56 minus F53. Now A5 equal to 2, A4 equal to 1, F56 equal to 0.1493, and F53 equal to 0.11643. So F45 equal to 0.0657. And similarly, A4 F42 equal to A2 F24. So F42 equal to A2 F24 divided by A4, which is A2 by A4 into, so F24 from this diagram, F26 minus F23. So A2 equal to 1, A4 equal to 1 into 0.23285 minus 0.2004, which is 0.03281. Now this F41, using the first relation, F41 equal to F45 minus F42, which is 0.0657 minus 0.03281 equal to 0.03289. So F41 equal to 0.03289. Now using the reciprocity rule once again, A1 F14 equal to A4 F41. So F14 equal to A4 F41 divided by A1. So A4 equal to 1. F41 in the previous calculation, 0.03289, A1 equal to 1. So the answer is 0.03289. So the answer, the shape factor, this is what you have to calculate, F14, which is 0.03289. This is the answer. And the example 13A, this is also from the university question paper. Find an expression for the geometric factor F11. For the inside surface of a black hemispherical cavity of radius r with respect to itself. So this is the hemispherical cavity. The hemisphere is 1, the surface of the hemisphere is 1, and the top circle equal to 2, and radius equal to r. And the area of the hemisphere equal to 2 pi r square, and the area of the surface, the top surface 2 equal to pi r square, and using the summation rule. So F11 plus F12 equal to 1. So here F11 equal to 1 minus F12. What is F11? Heat radiation leaving the surface 1, which is falling on the same surface, and F12 is radiation leaving the surface 1, which is falling on the surface 2. And F21 plus F22 equal to 1. So F22 equal to 0, because this radiation leaving from this surface, flat surface, is not at all falling on the same surface. Whatever the radiation leaving from the top flat surface, it is completely falling on only the surface 1. So F21 equal to 1. Now using the reciprocity rule, A1 F12 equal to A2 F21. So F12 equal to A2 F21 divided by A1, which is A2 equal to pi r square into 1 divided by 2 pi r square, which is 0.5. So F12 equal to 0.5. So therefore F11 equal to 1 minus F12, this is 1 minus 0.05, which is equal to 0.5. So the shape factor F11 is equal to 1 minus 0.5, this is equal to 0.5. That is the answer for the problem. We take another example, 13b. Find the expression for a geometry factor of F11 for the inside surface of a black cylindrical cavity of radius r and the length l with respect to itself. Now we have to find out the, we have a cavity, circular cavity, cylindrical cavity, and of top surface is 2, and the entire cavity is considered as 1. Now we have to calculate the shape factor. Now, area of the cylindrical cavity. So, the cylindrical cavity has two surfaces, the base circle plus the height. So, the base circle is pi r square plus 2 pi r into L. For the top surface, A2 equal to pi r square. Again, the same procedure from the summation rule, F11 equal plus F12 equal to 1. So, F11 equal to 1 minus F12 and F21 plus F22 equal to 1. So, F22 equal to 0 here. Therefore, F21 equal to 1. Using the reciprocity rule, A1 F12 equal to A2 F21. So, F12 equal to A1 A2 F21 divided by A1, this equal to pi r square into 1 divided by pi r square plus 2 pi r into L. So, simplifying, this will be r divided by r plus 2L. Now, using the shape factor for the cylindrical cavity, F11 equal to 1 minus F12. This is 1 minus r by r divided by r plus 2L. So, simplifying, the F11 equal to 2L by r into 2L. That is the answer. So, the shape factor of the cylindrical cavity with respect to itself, F11 equal to 2L by r plus 2L. So, we stop here and continue in the next lecture. And these are all the reference books I used for the lecture. So, you can also refer to it for further information. And this is the book what I have published earlier on this subject. You can refer to it. And if you have any queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. And I will sincerely answer to your queries. And thank you. We'll meet again.